A and B can do a piece of work in 72 days, B and C in 120 days, A and C in 90 days. In how many days all three together can do the work? Now observe this question very carefully. A, B can do it in 72 days, okay? B, C in 120 and A, C in 90. Now, who is more efficient? Obviously, A, B, when they join together, they are more efficient. They complete the work in 72 days. Now, if another person gives the support, you know, if C also joins and if he does a part of it, what will happen to the number of days? It will definitely reduce. So, when three of them come together, the number of days has to be less than 72, right? So, look at the options. The only option which is agreeing to this is option C, 60. That's all. All right. You don't have to actually solve this question. You can just look at the options, eliminate option three options and select this. Let's go to the next question. Read the question. A particular job can be done by 10 men in 12 days. Okay. So overall, there are 10 men and they can do the task in 12 days. The same job, if it was given to 10 women, they can do it in 6 days. So who is more efficient here? Women are more efficient than men in this particular question. How many days are needed to complete the job if two teams work together? Now, 10 women alone can do it in 6 days. If 10 men give the support, all right? So the number of days will definitely reduce. And look at the options. The options, except 4 days, the remaining are either equal to 6 or more than 6. So eliminate them. So you have only option A. That's it. It's quite simple, so easy. All right, you don't have to actually solve the problem. Next one. It's a very simple question, direct question. A and B together can complete it in 15 days. So if you consider the total amount of work as one unit, all right, so A and B, they complete 1 by 15th of the work in one day. Okay, this is one day's work. B alone can complete 1 by 20th of the work. Then what about A? C, you can either add or subtract the amount of work done by them, not the number of days. So that's why you always take the reciprocal in this chapter. So it is A's work per day is 1 by 15 minus 1 by 20. LCM is 60 and then you have 1 by 60. So 1 by 60 is the amount of work done by A in one day. That is 1 by 60th of the work. So if that is the case, the total number of days taken by him to complete the total work, what is that, is one unit, is nothing but the reciprocal of this, that is 60 days. So answer is 60. See, this is one approach to solve the problem. There's another way to solve the same problem. And how is that? It's called as LCM method. LCM method. So what you do, you take the LCM of these two values, whatever the numbers you see in the question. And then in this case, it becomes 60. So assume this to be total number of units. Total number of units of work to be completed. It can be a construction of wall wherein the number of units is total number of bricks, or anything. Basically, total number of units is 60 units. If that is the case, A and B together can complete this work in how many days? 15 days is what they have given. So if that is the case, 60 by 15 is 4 units. 4 units per day is the amount of work done by A and B in one day. All right. So similarly, look at B. B can do 3 units per day because it is 20 days. So 60 by 20 is 3. So if 3 units is done by B in one day, and A and B together can do 4 units, so remaining is contributed by who? A. It is A, and that is nothing but 1 unit per day. So if A can do 1 unit per day, that is his efficiency, to complete 60 units, which is total work, he takes 60 days. See, to explain this, this takes more time, but actually, this method, LCM method, is more effective than the fraction method because the calculations are pretty simple. Now, if you ask me to do it without explaining. So how would I do? I will first take LCM and then find out the value AB is 4 and then B is 3. So A is 1 unit per day, so 60. That's it. All right. So if you practice it, it becomes quite easy, very simple LCM method. I would suggest you to follow this. All right, next one. Great, a little tricky. Ronald and Elon. Ronald takes 6 hours to type 32 pages. So in 1 hour, he types 32 by 6. That is equal to 5.33 pages. Okay, in 1 hour. What about Elon? 40 by 5, 8 pages. So add them, you get 13.33 pages in 1 hour. So many pages in 1 hour. But what we are supposed to find out is when they work together. So when they're working together, that's why we have added the number of pages typed by them in 1 hour. So you have 110 pages here. So 110 divided by, that is a total number of pages, divided by 13.33 pages per hour should give you the total duration. Okay, so 110 by 13.33, I'll consider it as 13 1 by 3. So 13 1 by 3 becomes 13.3 or 39 plus 1, 40 by 3. So the whole value now you can simplify it as 33 by 4. So 33 by 4 will be equal to 4 8s are 32 and then 1 by 4 pending. 1 by 4 is 1 fourth of 60 minutes, that is equal to 15 minutes. So it is 8 hours, 15 minutes. Answer is option C. Next one. Next question. Don't go with the option that I have marked, just mark it simply. Read the question. A, B, C together, I'll assume they can do it in X hours. That is the case, A takes X plus 6, B takes X plus 1, and C takes 2X. Only then your statements will be right. Question is, what A and B together can do the job in how many hours? All right. Now, everything what we have mentioned here is, the unit is hours. In time and work, like I previously said, we equate the amount of work done by them, not the duration. So, amount of work done by A in 1 hour can be expressed in terms of 1 by x plus 6 of the total amount of work. So, this is A plus, similarly B is x plus 1, similarly C is this one. This must be equal to 1 by x. Why 1 by x? Because that is the total duration taken by all three of them working together. Great. When you solve this equation, it's a quadratic equation. Okay. Fine. Anyways, we'll solve it. 1 by x and 1 by 2x, I'll take that. So this becomes 1 by 2x is equal to x plus 6 into x plus 1. So you have sum of this. 2x plus 7, and then solve it, you must get x square plus 7x plus 6 equals to 4x square plus 14x. So this becomes 3x square plus 7x minus 6 is equal to 0. Factorize, product has to be minus 18, and this is 7x. So minus 9x and 2x, minus 9x and 2x, plus 9x minus 2x, because the sum is plus 7x, right? Yeah. So with that, you will factorize, you will get it as 3x into x plus 3 minus 2 into x plus 3 is equal to 0. That gives me the value of x to be equal to either 2 by 3 or minus 3. So excess duration, that is R. So I will remove that minus 3 because it has a negative sign. So the value of x is 2 by 3 hours. Now in the question, what they are asking is A and B together can do the job in how many hours? Okay. Now I have got ABC, that is this value. So what I should get is when A and B together. So it's pretty simple. What you can do is either add the value to this or subtract C from AB. That is the amount of work done, and take the reciprocal. So I will go with the addition. So A, this value will become 2 by 3 plus 6. 2 by 3 plus 6 is 6 2 by 3 or 18 20 by 3. And B value will be equal to 2 by 3 plus 1. So that is 5 by 3. Okay. So A and B, take the reciprocal, you will get 3 by 20 plus 3 by 5, which is 4 times. So I can write it as 12 by 20. So this is 15 by 20, or 15 by 20 is 3 by 4. 3 by 4 is what? 3 by 4 is the amount of work done by them, that is A and B together. So what we need is the duration. So we take the reciprocal of that, it becomes 4 by 3. Answer is option D, 4 by 3. A little confusing. I'm sure till this part it is quite clear. Till you get the value of x. Well, so once you get the value of x, I'll just repeat this for you. Once you get the value of x, you will get the duration of A and B individually, and that will be equal to x plus 6. What is x plus 6? So 6 2 by 3 becomes 20 by 3. Then what is x plus 1? That is the amount of time taken by B individually. That is 2 by 3, that will be equal to 5 by 3. Now you know the individual time. So how do you find out when they work together? This you have done it previously. When you find out that value, you will get 4 by 3, which is option D. That's all. Okay. So this problem is very algebraic, and since you don't have an absolute value, it is difficult to assume something and get the solution or follow the LCM method. So you have to solve this with the fraction method. If in case you guys have any better method than this, please put that in the comment box. Okay. So this one I would not go in the first go itself. Like, how would I take any mock test or any test is solve all the questions, the easier ones in the beginning, and then come back to the ones which I find it to be difficult, but to be difficult or time consuming, but I can solve it. So I will keep those questions in the end, and then I'll revisit it. So that this question would go to that revisit kind of questions. All right, great. Next one. All right. Next one. Easy question. X can do it in 4 hours. 1/4 is the amount of work done by him per hour. 1/4 of the total work. You can say it as 1/4. Now here it is 1/8. When they work together, it is going to be this. I'll make this 2/8. So the value is 3/8. The reciprocal of this is 8/3, which is equal to how much? 2 by 3, basically 2 plus 2 by 3. Okay, so that is nothing but 120 hours plus 2/3 of 1 hour. 2/3 of 60 is how much? 40 minutes. So 120 minutes plus 40 minutes will give you 160 minutes. Answer is option B. Well, read this question, understand it. They've said A can do it in 18 days. He worked at it for 12 days. So if he works at it for 12 days, so he must have completed how much of work? That is something which you need to calculate. So 18 days he completes the entire work. Now he works for 12 days. So that means he completes 12 by 18 part of the work, or which is nothing but 2 by 3. So 2/3 of the work is already completed by A. What is remaining? Remaining is 1/3. B finished the remaining work in 8 days. So now B completes 1/3 of task in 8 days. Then to complete the entire work, how many days is taken by B is the question. It's pretty simple. One third is completed in 8 days. To complete the entire work, he takes 8 into 3, that is 24 days. Right? Fantastic. Pretty simple. So 1/3 is 8 days. What is pending? Pending is plus 2/3. So he will take 8 plus 8 more days, 16 days. So 16 plus 8, which is equal to 24. You can calculate however comfortable you are. Well, even this question, without solving the question, you can get the answer just by reading the question. So they've said that a father can do a job as fast as his two sons working together. If one son does the job in 3 hours, another son in 6 hours, number of hours taken by the father, it's similar to number of hours taken by both of them working together. Now look at the options and look at the numbers given. 3 hours and 6 hours. So one son can do it in 3 hours with the help of other son. He can definitely do it in less than 3 hours. So option C and D eliminated. Now the next one, look at option A. It is 1 hour. Now, even if it is, for example, let's say if this is not 6 hours, instead this is 3 hours, all right, which is more efficient than the actual value given. So if the second son, if he can do in 3 hours instead of 6 hours, then the total work done by both of them would be 1.5, right, in 1.5 hours. Getting it? But this is more than that, you know, 6 hours is more than that. So the value has to be more than 1.5 hours. So option is 2. Option B, 2 hours. So you can also do it. If you 1/3 plus 1/6 is 2, this is 2/6, you get 3/6, reciprocal of this is 2. Anything is fine, all right? Conceptually, if you want to go without calculation, you can just get the answer. Great, next one, okay? See, these are different type of questions, all right? Now, whenever you have something like a group work, wherein, you know, they give around 10 men together can do the task in so many days, or 5 women can do it in so many days. So remember this thing, understand this concept. How we will be tackling these kind of questions is, we will find out the total man days. Now, what is the meaning of this man days? It's pretty simple. Assume that every day you change this 35 men. Okay, every day there's a unique set of men, and the efficiency of every man is same. So with that, what is the total number of men involved in this project? That is nothing but 35 into 8. So this number is nothing but, it gives you the total amount of work done by this particular group, assuming the efficiency of each man is same. This must be equal to, if the same amount of work has to be accomplished, that must be equal to 10 days multiplied by the number of men required to complete. In how many days? 10 days. Obviously, you can see this number has increased. Definitely, the n has to be less than 35. So you have 3 options. So you have to solve it. So it is 35 into 8 divided by 10, which will be equal to how much? How do you simplify this? 7, 5 7s are and 5 2s are, 4s are, 7 4s are, 28. Option B. Great. Next one. All right. Next question. So whenever you have questions, something like, you know, A leaves somewhere in between or B leaves somewhere in between, I would suggest go with the LCM method. We will see both fraction and LCM and see the difference between them. First, anyways, we'll go with the conventional fraction method. So 1/6 is the amount of work done by A in 1 day, 1/B, 1/12, that is 1/B only, 1/12. So when I add this, I will get the amount of work accomplished by both A and B working together. That will be equal to 2/12, 3/12, 3/12 is 1/4. 1/4 of the task will be completed by them in 1 day. So in 3 days, they complete 3/4 of the task. So pending is 1/4. Now this has to be done only by B. Clear? But we know that B can complete 1/12. But he has to complete 1/4 of it. So 1/4 divided by 1/12 gives me 3 days. So the extra days what B will be working for is 3 days. Then total number of days needed for the completion of the work is initially 3 days, and then extra 3 days worked by B alone gives me 6 days. Option C. So this is fraction method. What is LCM method? LCM method is 6 and 12. I'll take the total work done as 12 units. A can do 2 units in a day. B can do 1 unit per day. So in 3 days, they have completed 3 into 3, 9 units. Okay, pending is 3 units. So this 3 units can be completed by B in 3 days because his efficiency is 1 unit. So 3 days by B and initially 3 days by both A and B gives me answer 6. So LCM method is something which I follow. It's very, very simple. If you are used to fraction method and if you can do it quickly, easily, the fractions multiplication, I mean the calculations and all that, go proceed with the fraction, no problems. Great, next one. Okay, like I said in the previous questions, I guess, I think it's 9th one. So yeah, something similar to the 9th one. So what we'll do here is we equate the man days. So in the first scenario, it is 55 days into, let's say, n number of men must be equal to, if there were 6% more, so it is n plus 6. Work would get over 11 days less. So it is in 44 days. Okay, you multiply it. This 55n is equal to 44n plus, I'll keep this, like, you know, I will not simplify it because there's a chance of simplification. So this is 44, sorry. N is equal to 11, 4 times, so n is 24. So the value of n is 24. How many persons were originally there? It is n, that is 24. Option B. Simple. All right, next one. This is similar to question number 10. Similar to that. Let's see. I told you that, you know, we can go with both fraction and LCM. I'll go with LCM. 15 and 10. 30 units, I'll assume that to be the total work. Then A can complete 2 units per day. B, 3 units per day. They started doing the work together, but after 2 days, so in 2 days, they have completed 3 plus 2, 5 into 2, 10 units in 2 days. B had to leave and A alone completed the remaining work. Now A alone completes how much? 10 units is over out of 30 units. So pending is 20 units. Now we know that the efficiency of A is 2 units per day. Okay. So he takes 20 units divided by 2 units, that is 10 days to complete the remaining work. So whole work was completed in 10 days here, and then A and B working together for 2 days. That is 10 plus 2, 12. Option C. Simple? Great. Next one. All right, go to the next one. Now this is not the right option, I just marked it randomly. A and B working together, sorry, working separately, can do a piece of work in 9 and 12 days respectively. If they work for a day alternately with A beginning, so it's something like this. You have A works for first day and then B and then A. In this fashion, they start working. So in how many days would they complete the task? If A can complete in 9 days and B alone can do it in 12 days. Now, for this as well, I will go with the LCM approach. LCM of 9 and 12 is 36. So, efficiency of A is 4 units per day and B is 3 units per day. 36 by 9, 36 by 12. So, in 2 days, A and B completes 7 units in 2 days. In 10 days, they will complete 35 units. So how did I get that? I multiplied this by 5 and this also by 5. Now why did I end up with 35? Because maximum amount of work to be done is 36 units and the multiple of 7 units less than 36 is 35. So in 10 days, 35 units of work gets completed. Now let's see who works on 11th day. 11 is an odd number and they have clearly mentioned starting with A. So A will be the person who will be working on 11th day. The efficiency of A is 4 units per day. The pending amount is 1 unit. That is 36 minus 35. Now, A completes this 1 unit in 1/4 of the day because his efficiency is 4 units and the pending work is 1 unit. So, 11th day, he takes 1/4 of it, so it's going to be 10 days overall plus 1/4, which is nothing but 10 1/4. Option C. Great. Next one. All right. Next question. Read the question. A, B together in 30 days, they can finish it. They worked at it for 20 days. So that means they have completed 2/3 of the task. Right? So 30 days is the is the time that they can finish the work, and they have worked for 20 days. So they have completed 2 parts out of 3 parts, right? So 2/3 of the work is over. Remaining is how much? 1/3. And this is done by B, is what they have given. The remaining work was done by A. The remaining work was done by A alone in 20 more days. So now observe this. If 1/3 of the task can be done by A in 20 days, all right, then the complete work is the question. A alone can finish the work in. If 1/3 can be done in 20 days, the entire work can be done in 20 into 3, 60 days. I hope this is clear. So 1/3 of the part is done in 20 days. So remaining 2/3 of the part will be done in 20 plus 20 days, which is nothing but 40 plus 20, 60 days. Clear? Option A. Now, can we do this with LCM method? Definitely we can do. But since you have, it's very clearly mentioned, together they can do in 30 days and they work at it for 20 days. So you get these easy fractions, 2/3, and then you have 1/3, and then into 3. So it's easier now. How to decide between LCM and a fraction? There is no fixed rule. Okay, if there are complications in terms of fractions, there are too many fractions involved, then usually I would prefer going with the LCM method. If it's an algebraic expression completely, then there is no way in which you can solve with the LCM method. You have to go with the fraction. So knowing both the methods is very important, and it's going to be really effective. Great. Next one. Okay. So individual days is given, 45 and 40. They began the work, A left after some days, B finished the remaining work in 23 days. Now see, it's something like this. I'll draw this in a timeline. Now A and B are working together. After some days, A leaves, and then B continues and works for 23 days. Now this is what is absolute. Okay, so B is here. From this part to this part, 23 days. Now I'll start the solution from this end. Okay. Now, if B can do the work in 40 days, all right. So 1/40 is the amount of work done by B, and he works for 23 days. So amount of work that he would have accomplished is 23/40, which is more than 50%. Okay. The question is, A left after how many days? Now, 1 minus 23/40 is the total amount of work done by both A and B together. Assuming 1 to be the total work to be done, and B completes 23/40th of the total work, right? So this is going to be 17/40 total work, fine. And then you have A and B working together is 45 days and 40 days. So together when they work, it is 1/45 plus 1/40. Which will be equal to 45 and 40. So you can go with 5 into 8 into 9. Yeah. So this will be 8 plus 9, which is once again 17. So 17 divided by 40 into 9. I'll keep it as 40 into 9 because I have 40 here. Things get cancelled. Right. Now this is the total remaining work, and this is the efficiency of A and B, that is amount of work done by them in one day. Now, how do I get the amount number of days that they have worked together? That is nothing but this value divided by 17/40 into 9, and you get 9 days. So 9 days is when they have worked together. So that means after 9 days, A leaves. So the answer is option B, D, 9 days. Okay, if you are confused, once again, watch the video. I'm sure you'll get the clarity. It's very simple. It's just that, there are some minute adjustments which you're supposed to do. That's all. Great. Next one. Ram and Hari, they can cut 12 kgs nuts in 2 days. That means they can cut 6 kg in 1 day. After 5 days, Hari left the work. Ram took 8 more days to cut the rest of the nuts. But we don't know the efficiency of individually, like Ram or Hari. Okay. If total of 58 kgs of nuts were cut, oh, they have given a total kgs. So this is sufficient for us to find the value. I mean the efficiency of both H and R. How is that? Let's do it. So 6 kgs can be cut by both Ram and Hari in 1 day. So in 5 days they will cut 30 kgs of nuts. They have clearly mentioned 58 kgs is the total amount of nuts. So pending is how much? 28 kgs. And this 28 kgs is cut by Ram alone. And he takes 28 by, oh sorry, he takes 8 more days. So that means his efficiency, that is Ram's efficiency, is 28 divided by 8 days. 28 kg divided by 8 days. So that gives you the efficiency of Ram. Now, let's calculate this. All right. So 28 by 8 will be equal to 4, sorry, 4, 7, 7 by 2. 7 by 2 kg per day. Now, we know that in 1 day, Hari and Ram can cut 6 kgs. So 6 kgs must be equal to 7 by 2 plus the number of nuts that Hari can cut in 1 day. All right. So that will be equal to 7 by 2 is 3.5. 6 minus 3.5 is 2.5. Or Hari's 1 day efficiency is 5 by 2, 2.5, 2.5 kgs. In the question, what they have asked is time taken by Hari to cut 10 kgs of nuts. So in 1 day he cuts 2.5 kgs. So to cut 10 kgs he will take 2.5 into 4. So 2.5 kgs in 1 day multiplied by 4, you get 10 kgs. So answer is 4 days. I'm going a little faster. So please watch the video once again if in case you're getting stuck somewhere or if you are not able to follow it. We have some time constraints. We're solving these questions as soon as possible. We want to complete it with clarity, of course. Well, okay. Next one. Next one. Again, man-days concept. Okay. Man-days concept. I think 10th or 11th question is similar kind of one, but there's a little small twist here. 15 men can finish a piece of work in 40 days. So overall, man days is 15 into 40. This is the total amount of work. This is how you calculate when it comes to the group work concept. The number of days after which 5 men should leave. So initially, there are 15 men and they work for, let's say, D number of days. All right. And then 5 men leave. So this becomes 10. So the remaining number of days is 45 minus D, because it's clearly mentioned that so that the work is finished in overall 45 days in this case. Hope this is very clear, right? Solve this equation. 15D plus 10 into 45 is 450 minus 10D. This becomes 5D plus 450 is equal to 15 into 40. So 15 into 40 is 400. 5 into 40 is 200, 600. And D is equal to 600 minus 450 is 150 divided by 5, you will get 30. So after 30 days, all right, 5 men will leave. So in the question is the number of days after which 5 men should leave. So answer is correct. That is option C, 30. Great. Next one. Okay. Next one. Well, when you have questions something like 8 men or sorry, 5 men or 8 women can do a piece of work in 12 days. So what does this mean? The efficiency of 5 men is equal to the efficiency of 8 women. All right. Well, that's the first conclusion that you can make. 5 men are equivalent to 8 women. Then Next thing is, they can do in 12 days. Alright. How many days will be taken by 2 men and 4 women? Now, 2 men and 4 women, I have to express this number of women in terms of number of men. So, if 8 women is equivalent to 5 men, 4 women will be equivalent to 2.5 men. This will be this. So, overall, it is 4.5 men now. Question is, 5 men can do the task in 12 days. So, 4.5 men can do it in how many days? Don't cross multiply. You cross multiply only when these values are directly proportional. Here, when the number of men increases, the number of days reduces. So, if the number of men has reduced, the number of days must increase. So, it's not a cross multiplication. So, that's why we go with the man days concept, right? So, 5 into 12 must be equal to, that is number of men and number of days in the first scene, must be equal to number of men. 4.5, I will write in terms of 9 by 5. Let's see if that becomes easier. Not 9 by 5, 9 by 2, right? Multiplied by the number of days. So, that will be 10 into 12 by 9 or 120 by 9. 120 by 9 will be equal to how much? 10s are 90, 3s are 27. 90 plus 27 is 117. So, 13, 3 by 9 or 13, 1 by 3 or 13.33 days. Option C. Hope this is clear. Next one. 4 men and 6 women can complete a work in 8 days. So, what I will do is, I will take the efficiency of men as M, that is the amount of work done by them, work done by one man in one day, okay, as M, and the efficiency of women or one woman is W. So, that gives me 4M plus 6W is equal to not 8 days. That cannot be 8 days. So, what we can equate? We can only equate the amount of work done by the people, not the number of days. We cannot add the number of days directly. All right. So, that will be equal to the efficiency, amount of work done by 4 men and 6 women is 1 by 8, 1 by 8 of the total work. Great. So, 4m plus 6w is 1 by 8. Similarly, 3m plus 7w must be equal to 1 by 10. What I want is, if w is the efficiency, what I want is 1 by 10w. Now, why is that I want 1 by 10w? Because in how many days will 10 women complete it? Now, if I get the value of 10W, that gives me the efficiency of 10 men. So, what is efficiency of 10 men? The amount of, the part of the work done by 10 women in one day. My mistake, not men, women in one day, right? So, here, to solve this equation, I will multiply. I mean, this is fourth standard, voila, you know, simplifying two equations. So, you do this, you will get 12m, and then you get 18 women equal to 3 by 8. Similarly, here you get 7 women into 4, that is 28 women equal to 4 by 10. When you subtract, your this part gets cancelled. So, I am not writing it here. Fine. So, 10 women will be equal to this minus this LCM. Can take it as 40. So, 16 minus 8, 5 is a 5 to the 15. So, it is 1 by 40. Now, see, 10 women is 1 by 40. What does this mean? The efficiency of 10 women is 1 by 40. Now, what is that I want? I want 1 by 10W. So, 10W is 140. 1 by 40, so 1 by 10W will be equal to 40. Answer is option C, 40 days. Next one. Look at this. So, read the question, you'll understand what I'm trying to do. LCM, I'll take it as 120. 12 plus 5 is 17. 1 by 6, I'll express in terms of 120, so this into 20 is 20. 3 by 120. Or option C. By now, you should have figured out what I've done. Very simple question. So answer is 40. Great. Next one. Okay. I have marked it as 8 by 15. Just solve it. This is a simple question. I'm sure if you have taken the mock test, you must have solved it. A can do a work in 15 days, B in 20 days. So efficiency is 1 by 15, 1 by 20. If they work together for 4 days, so together their efficiency is 7 by 60. 15 4 times, 23 times, so 7 by 60. That is per day. So 7 by 60 multiplied by 4 gives you the amount of work or the fraction of work done by them in 4 days. So what is left out is 1 minus this value, right? So that will be equal to 1 minus 7 by 15 or 8 by 15. Great. So the same thing, you can solve it with LCM method. How is that? 15, 20, take 60 as the total unit of work. A, efficiency of A in this case will be 4 units. B, it will be 3 units. So together 7 units. In 4 days they complete 28 units. Pending is 32 units. 60 minus 28. Now 32 is pending. Fraction is nothing but 32 divided by 60. Great. So that will be equal to 4 how many times? 4 8 times and then 4 15 times. So with both the methods you can get the answer, you will get the same answer, obviously. Next one. Okay. Look at this question. A does 7/10th part of work in 15 days. After that, he completes the remaining work in 4 days with the help of B. Okay. Well, so you have a fraction what is given. A does 7 by 10th of the work in 15 days. Okay, so what is remaining? Remaining is 3 by 10. This is done by both A and B in how many days? 4 days. Question is, in how many days will A and B together do the same work? Now, if 3 by 10th of the work is done by A and B in 4 days, okay, then remaining 7 by 10th of the work can be done by A and B in how many days is what we are supposed to find out. So I'll split this number as 3 by 10, 3 by 10, 1 by 10. So I can do 3 by 10 of this, this part I can do it in 4 days, similarly this in 4 days. And if I can do 3 by 10th of the task in 4 days, then what is 1 by 10? 1 third of this value. So I can complete this part in 4 by 3 days. So overall it is 4 plus 4 plus 4, 12. 12 plus 4 by 3 is 13, 1 by 3. Which is nothing but option C, 13.33 days. Clear? Next one. All right, next one. Yeah. A can complete 1 third of a work in 5 days. And B two-fifths of the work in 10 days. In how many days both A and B together can complete the work? So if I get the number of days taken by A as well as B independently to complete the total work, if I get that for both A and B, I can easily do it for together, correct? So with this given data, A can complete one third of the work in 5 days. So if that is the case, I'll directly write in 15 days he will complete the entire work. Okay, it's very simple. One third can be done in 5 days. So total work 5 into 3, 15 days. Two fifth of the work in 10 days. So total work can be done in 10 divided by 2/5. That is equal to 25 days. So once you get these two values, next is pretty simple. LCM, it is 25, 50, so 150. Okay, so 15 10 times and then 25 6 times. So the reciprocal of that will be this value, which is a little less than 10. So I'll go with option 9, 3 by 8. I need not even solve it. All right. Option B, if you want to cross verify, you can just do it. 16, 9 times is how much? 144. Remainder is 6. So 6 by 16, which is 3 by 8. Clear? Great. Next one. All right. Read the question. Here, whenever you have group work and the amount of work is also given, you follow this rule, that is M1 D1 by W1 is equal to M2 D2 by W2. W2 is the work. It could be in terms of number of days or it can be a fraction. M1 in this case, so basically what they're saying is for the first 60 days, 60 men have been deployed. Multiply this by how many days? That is first 60 days. And in the 60 days duration, they complete 3/4 of the work. So this must be equal to M2 is something that we don't know. And D2 is the project has to complete exactly on time. So that means the remaining days is 90 minus 60, 30 days. Divided by what is the left out work? 1/4 of it. That's it. So M2 is equal to 40 men. So you need 40 men for the last 30 days to complete 1/4 of the remaining work. So if you need 40 men, you will discard 20 out of the 60 that is total. So it is 60 minus 40, 20. Is the answer option B. Next one. All right, now read this question. A does half as much work as B in 3/4 of the time. Let's assume B completes the work in X days. Alright, so if that is the case, A does half of it in 3/4 of the time, it means 3/4 of X. If A can do half of it in 3/4 of X, then A can complete the work individually in double of this. If he can do half of it in so much of time, then the remaining half will take the same amount of time. So you add it or you double it, that will be equal to 3 by 2 x. So now I have the individual time taken by A as well as individual time taken by B. They have clearly mentioned together they take 18 days. All right, now you equate the amount of work done by them individually to the final value, that is equal to, I mean, let's do it. 1 by x is the fraction of work done by B in one day. 1 by 3 by 2 x, I'll write it as 2 by 3 x. The reciprocal of this is the fraction of work done by A in one day. So this is of B and this is of A. This must be equal to 1 by 18 because it's clearly given they complete the work in 18 days. When you solve it, you get this is 3x, 5, 1 by 18, 5, x is equal to 30 days. So B alone can complete the work in 30 days because we have assumed that to be equal to x. So the answer is 30 days, option A. Hope this is clear. Let's go to the next one. All right. Next one. A company employed 200 workers to complete a certain task in 150 days. If only 1/4 of the work has been done in 50 days, then in order to complete the whole work in time, the number of additional workers to be employed was great. So we have done similar kind of question. We'll implement m1 d1 by w1 should be equal to constant, that is m2 d2 by w2 here. So what is m1 d1 by w1? M1 is nothing but 200 workers and d1 is going to be 50 days. So in 50 days they have completed 1/4 of the work. This must be equal to m2 is what we need, and d2 is it has to happen on time. So remaining number of days is 100 divided by w2 is 3/4 of the remaining work. So you do this, you will get m2 is equal to 300. So the value of m2 is 300. So the question says the number of additional workers to be employed. Already there are 200 workers. So additionally, you need to deploy another 100 people. So answer is option A. Next one. Look at this. A little different from the previous ones. A, B, C are employed to do a piece of work for so much of money. 5290 together. Okay. So three of them get 5290, and when they get the money, they share the amount based on the amount of work they've done. That's the common sense that we have to apply here. A and B together are supposed to do so much of work, 19 by 23rd of the work. B and C together, 8 by 23rd of the work. Then A should be paid. Now observe very clearly. Now I need to get the fraction of work done by A. Now, here they have clearly mentioned B and C together, they complete 8 by 23 of the work. Then the remaining part is done by A alone. Is that clear? Now, we don't need this part of the question at all to solve this question, to get the answer for this. So, 8 by 3 is done by B and C, 8 by 23. So, A, the fraction of work done by A will be 1 minus 8 by 23, which will be equal to 23 minus 8, that is 15 by 23. Now 15 by 23 is the fraction of work done by A. So this multiplied by total amount of money that they get should be your answer. Clear? So 23, 2 times 46. Reminder is 6, so 23 3 times, so it is 230. 15 into 230, you will get 3000 plus 450. So that will be equal to option B. Now, this multiplication you can do however you want. So, what I do is 15 into 200 is 3000, and 15 into 30 is 450. So, it is 3450. Great. See, now there will be few questions wherein there will be extra data in the question which is not required to solve. It is just there to confuse you. So don't fall into the trap. Okay, great. Next one. Well, okay. Read the question. Great. Now, easy one. There are some calculations, that's all. Let's find out the individual time taken by three of them to complete the work. Okay, John does half of the work in 3 hours. So it means to completely finish, he will take 6 hours. All right. Let's say Joe. Joe, he does 1/4 of the remaining work. Now, remaining work, 1/4 of the remaining. Remaining is half. So, 1/4 of that is how much? 1 by 8. To do this task, he takes 1 hour. Then, if that is the case, Joe takes 8 hours to complete the work. Because to complete 1/8, he takes 1 hour. So to complete the entire work, you divide 1 divided by 1 by 8, you get 8 hours. Now let's go to George. Well, George, it's given that he finishes the remaining work in 5 hours. Now, what is the remaining work? Remaining work is 1 minus half, which is done by John, plus 1 by 8, which is done by Joe. Okay, let's calculate this value. This is going to be 8 and 2, 4 plus 1, 5 by 8. So 1 minus 5 by 8 is 3 by 8. To complete 3 by 8 of the work, George takes 5 hours. So to complete the entire work, he takes 5 divided by 3 by 8, which is equal to 40 by 3 hours. Alright, so now you have everything. You have the time taken by John, Joe and George individually. Now you can, what you can do is immediately go and add these three values, 6 hours, 1 hour and this one. So that will be, I mean, not add, take the reciprocal of that and add. That will give you the total work done by them. And if you take the reciprocal of that, you will find out how long have they taken. So it is nothing but 1/6 plus 1/8, oh sorry, not this, it is this one, plus 3/40. This will be equal to 6, 8 and 40. When you have these numbers and when there is a big number, to find out the LCM, just go with the multiples of that number. 40, 80, 80, 6 is not, 8 is not a multiple of 6. Next number is 120. 120, yes. So 6, 20 times, and 8, 15 times, and then 40, 3 times. So 3 into 3, 9. The numerator will be equal to how much? 24 plus 20, 44. 44 by 120. So 4, 11 times, 4, 30 times. Reciprocal of this is going to be 30 divided by 11, which is 11 twos are 22. 8 by 11 is the remainder, right? So 2 8 by 11, that is option D. Great. Next one. Okay, let's go to the next one. Simple question, small twist. A and B together can complete a work in 24 days. Okay. A alone does 1/3 part of this work in 12 days. B alone does 1/3 part of this work in 12 days. So, if that is the case, B completes the entire work in 36 days. Because 1/3 of it is done in 12 days. So, into 3, you will get 36 days. How many days will A alone take to complete the remaining work? Now, remaining work is how much? 2/3 of it. So, let's first find out the total number of days taken by A individually to complete it, which is quite easier to solve. And how is that? 124 minus 1 by 36. This should give me the value of the fraction of work done by A. With that, when you take the reciprocal, you will get the number of days taken by A to complete the work. Great. So this is equal to multiples of 36, 72. So 24 3 times and 2 times. So it is 1 by 72. So A's fraction of work is this. So number of days taken by A to complete it is 72 days. But what we have to find out is how many days will A alone take to complete the remaining work? All right. So remaining work is 2 by 3. That's it. So this is going to be 2 times, 4 times. So 24 into 2 is 48. Option C. Okay, read this question. This is a little different from the others what we have solved. P can do 1/4 of the work in 10 days. Q can do 40% of work in 40 days. R can do 1/3 in 13 days. Who will complete the work first? Well, you just have to express that. It's a ratio kind of problem. It's not, time and work. Anyways, the overall concept is time and work. Fine. So P can do 1/4 of the work in 10 days. So that means P can complete the work in 40 days. Right? 40 days. So Q can do 40% of work in 40 days. Can I say Q can do 10% of work in 10 days? If that is the case, he can complete 100% of work in how many days? 100 days. Right? Simple. 100 days. R can do 1/3 of the work in 13 days. So that means R can do the complete work in 13 into 3, 39 days. Who will complete the work first? Obviously R in 39 days. So it's option C. Next one. Let's solve this. A is twice as good a workman as B. So what does this mean? If B takes 2x number of days to complete some task, A takes how much? Is it 4x or x? It is x. If B takes 2x number of days to complete some task and A takes x number of days to complete the same task, then we can say A is twice as good a workman as B. Similarly, if I have to say B is twice as good a workman as C, then C must do this the same task in 4x days. I hope this is clear. This part is clear. All right. Now, if A and B can together finish a piece of work in 4 days, all right, then C can do it by himself in. Now, we know how to express this particular condition. We have to equate the amount of work done, not the number of days. So the amount of work done by A and B, let's say in 1 day, is nothing but 1 by 2x, that is of B, plus 1 by x, that is of A, must be equal to 1 by 4. If they complete the work in 4 days, in 1 day, they would have done 1/4 of the task. So equate this, you will get 6. But here we clearly know C takes 4x days. So it's going to be 4 into 6, 24 days. Option C. Okay, the trick is here to understand and express it in terms of proper number of days. Well, let's go to the next. Okay, next one. A is 50% as efficient as B, similar to the previous one. Okay, so let's assume B does the task in x days. Then to satisfy this equation, the sentence, A is 50% as efficient. That means A takes 2x number of days to complete the same task. C does half of the work done by A and B together. So let's keep this sentence right now. We'll not try to express that in terms of x. Let's read it completely. If C alone does the work in 20 days, then A, B and C together can do the work in. Now, this question is actually very simple. We don't even need these values to solve it. How? Let's see. C alone does the work in 20 days. So the amount of work done by C in 1 day is 1 by 20. That is of C. And then this sentence is C does half of the work done by A and B together. So what does that mean? A and B together, they will do double the work done by C. So here we have 1 by 20, the amount of work done by C. Then A and B has to do 2 times the work done by C, which is nothing but 1 by 10. So A plus b plus c will become 1 by 20 plus 1 by 10, which is equal to 20 and 3. The answer is reciprocal of this, which is 20 by 3 or 6 2 by 3. 6 2 by 3 is your answer. Clear? So, very simple question. You know, you can be confused. You can also use this data to solve it, but it is not necessary. When you don't have the necessity, if you know, simply implement all the equations, it will just ruin your time. Great. I hope this is clear. Let's go to the next one now. Okay. Solve this. I have marked it as 22.5. Let's see if that is right. A is thrice as good a workman as B. So I'll assume the number of days taken by B as 3x, so that I can write the number of days taken by A to complete the same task as x. A is thrice as good a workman as B and is therefore able to finish a piece of work in 60 days less than B. Now, what they are saying is the number of days taken by A, that is x, is equal to 60 days less than B, that is 3x minus 60. You have the answer in the question itself, right? So 2x is equal to 60, or x is equal to 30. Now, what is the value of x, that is 30, and what is that? It is the number of days taken by A to complete the task. But the question is the time in days in which they can do it working together. So A, you have found out to be 30 days. So B, it's going to be 90 days. All right. If B individually works, he takes 90 days. When they work together, it is going to be 1 by 30 plus 1 by 90. Whatever answer you get, the reciprocal of that, right? So 1 by 30 plus 1 by 90, it is 4 by 90. Reciprocal of this, you will get 4, 22 times 88, and you have 2 as the reminder, 2 by 4 is 0.5. 22.5. Perfect. Great. Move on to the next one. Next one. Kamal can do a work in 15 days. Bimal is 50% more efficient than Kamal. Now, 50% more efficient than Kamal. What does this mean? Now, whenever you have a comparison in terms of efficiency, first find out the values in terms of the amount of work done. But here, what we have is in terms of number of days. Now, if Kamal can do a work in 15 days, he can complete 1 by 15th of the work in one day. So this is the amount of work or the fraction of work. Now it makes sense to compare, and it is easier for us to visualize and understand. Now Bimal is 50% more. What does this mean? If Kamal can do 1 15th of the work, then Bimal can do obviously 1 by 15th plus 50% more, that is nothing but half of 1 by 15th. All right. The same thing we can also express in terms of 50% more efficient is nothing but 1.5 times the amount of work done by Kamal. Both are same. So you will also get the same value here. Let's do it. So 1 by 15 plus half of 1 by 15. Your LCM is 30 here. And then you have 2 plus 1. 3 by 30 or 1 by 10. Okay. Similarly, 1 by 15 into 1.5 is also 1 by 10. Great. Anything is fine. You can go with this itself. This is much easier. Understand it. That's all. So, in how many days will Bimal do that work? 1 by 10th is the fraction of work done by Bimal in one day. So, the reciprocal of that gives you the number of days taken by Bimal, which is nothing but 10 days. Option C. Great. Next one. All right. Now, A can do a piece of work in 6 days. B is 25% more efficient than A. Similar kind of question. How long would B alone take to finish this work? Now, I will do this little faster. Just observe 1 by 6 and then 1.25. Reciprocal of this must give me the answer. That is 600 divided by 125. Now, this says 125 to 250, 125 4 times 500. So, 400 by 125. That is 4 by 5. 25 4 times 5 times. Answer is 4 by 5. I hope you have understood this. What I have done here, initially I have found out the fraction of work done by A, that is 1 by 6. If B is 25% more efficient than A, then the amount of work done by B in one day is going to be 1.25 times 1 by 6. Great. Now, this is the fraction of work done by B in one day. Now, what I need is the number of days taken by B to complete the work, which will be the reciprocal of that. So, instead of doing the calculation here, I have just taken the reciprocal, and to move the decimal, I have multiplied both numerator and denominator by 100, 600 by 125, and then your calculation, you get the answer. Simple. Next one. Great. Let's move on to the next one. If A, B, and C can complete a work in 6 days, if A can work twice faster than B, what does this mean? A takes half the time taken by B, and thrice faster than C. That means A takes one third the time taken by C. So what I'll assume A takes X number of days, all right? Then B takes 2X and C 3X. That's all. So once your assumption is right, this value is correct, the next part is pretty simple. Next is 1 by X plus 1 by 2X plus 1 by 3X must be equal to 1 by 6. This is 6X. Then you have 6 plus 3 plus 2, which is equal to 1 by 6. So the value of X, you get 11. 6 plus 3 plus 2. Now, 11 is the value of X. What they have asked is number of days C alone can complete the work. That is 3 into 11, 33. Option A. Great. Next one. All right. A man does double the work done by a boy in the same time. That means the efficiency of man is 2 times the efficiency of a boy. All right. The number of days that 3 men and 4 boys will take to finish a work which can be done by 10 men in 8 days is. So with this statement, what we can understand is 10 men can complete this task in 8 days. So what they are looking for is 3 men and 4 boys. Now I have to express this 4 boys in terms of number of men. And that is pretty simple. 4 boys is equivalent to 2 men. Why? 1 man is equivalent to 2 boys in terms of efficiency. So 4 boys will become 3 men, 2 men, and already you have 3 men. So this will be equal to 5 men. 10 men can do the work in 8 days, then 5 men will take 16 days to complete the task. You can just do it even without calculation. You know, the number of men has reduced by half, so the number of days will become double. So that M1 into D1 is constant, or M into D is constant. Great. Option B. Next one. Okay. This one is pretty simple. You know, we have already done this, something similar. This is M1 into D1 by W1 is equal to M2 D2 by W2, wherein the work is expressed in terms of the length of the wall, 280, and then you have 100. So initially M1 is 72, or the number of men is 72, number of days is 21, this is 280. Must be equal to M2, we don't know, and D2 is 18 days and the work is 100 meters. I'll skip the step. So M2 will be equal to 100 divided by 18. 18 how many times? 4 times. 4, 7, 7, 3. 3 into 10, 30. Answer is option A. Hope this is clear. Let's go to the next one. Similar question, but a small twist. A wall of 100 meters can be built by 7 men or 10 women. So they are saying seven men are equivalent to 10 women. Okay. And then they have also given the amount of work, that is, 100 meters and 60 meters. So your equation here would be number of men into number of days divided by the work is constant. Okay, great. Now the confusion here is they have asked something like 14 men and 20 women. You will have to express this in terms of either number of men or number of women, that's all. So before that, the first equation is number of men, I'll go with number of men, that is 7 men, multiplied by the number of days is 10, divided by the work is 100 meters. This must be equal to 14 men and 20 women. Now observe this, 20 women, 10 women are equivalent to 7 men. So 20 women will be equivalent to 14 men. Hope this is clear. 10 women are equivalent to 7 men. So 20 women will be equivalent to 14 men. I hope this is very clear. So 14 men and 14 men will be equal to 28 men, multiplied by the number of days which we are supposed to calculate, divided by 600 meters. Yes, great. 6 times, 4 times, you have 60 by 4, days is 15. How many days will they take? They'll take 15 days, option A. All right, next one. 5 persons can prepare an admission list in 8 days, working 7 hours a day. Now they have included the duration also. Now listen very carefully. Now while I was saying number of men into number of days is constant, what is this? That is nothing but the duration overall. And the unit was days. This can be hours, this can be minutes, or it can be any other unit of time. But it is basically the time duration. All right. In this case, it's going to be number of men into number of hours, which is equal to days into hours worked per day. Okay, that is nothing but number of men is 5 multiplied by days. They have mentioned 8 days working 7 hours a day. This must be equal to, if 2 persons join them, the number of men will be 7 and they have to complete the work in 4 days. And let's assume H as the duration that they are supposed to work per day. So the value of H will be equal to 5 into 8 into 7 divided by 7 into 4, 10 hours. Great. Next one. Okay. 24 men can complete a piece of work in 17 days. How many men will be able to do it in 51 days? Number of days has increased by what fraction? Into 3. So the number of men will reduce, will become 1/3 of it. Simple as that. It is 24 by 3, which is 8. If I have to elaborate it again, M1 D1 must be equal to M2 D2. M1 D1 is 24 into 17. This must be equal to number of men into days is 51. So it will be, this value is going to be 51. Great. Next one. Okay. Now, Suman can do a piece of work. Suman can do a work in 3 days. Sumati can do the same work in 2 days. Now, both of them finish the work together and get rupees 150. What is the share of Suman? Now, who should get more? Is it Suman or Sumati? So who is more efficient? Whoever is more efficient, that person should get more money. Now, Suman can do in 3 and Sumati in 2. So Sumati is more efficient. So Suman has to get less than 75 rupees. That is the logic. Now there are 3 options there, 30, 60 and 70. So we can't rule out the options and we'll have to solve it. It's pretty simple. In fact, the amount is shared in the ratio of their efficiency, the amount of work done. Suman and Sumati. Okay, ST is Sumati, fine. The ratio of work done by them is 1 by 3 is to 1 by 2, which is nothing but 2 is to 3. We are looking at Suman's share. So this will be 2 by 5. That is 2 plus 3 is 5 of 150 rupees. Option B. That's it. Next one. Okay. Three persons undertake to complete a piece of work for 1200 rupees. 1200 rupees, paise, whatever. Some unit. The first person can complete the work in 8 days. So the question is, what does the fourth person get? So we should be interested in terms of, we should be interested about the efficiency, the amount of work done by them. So what I'll do is I'll express all these values in terms of the fraction of work. A, it is 1 by 8. B, it's 1 by 12, second person. And then 1 by 16. Fourth person is not given, but they have mentioned the sum of this plus, let's say, the fourth person is equal to 1 by 3. 1 by 3 minus, find out this. I mean, instead of 1 by 3 minus, what I will do is 1 by f is equal to, I'll take the LCM of 8, 12, 16, and 3. That is 16 3 times is 48. Okay, so 3, how many times is 48? 16, right? So 16 minus 8, 6 za, 12, 3 za. 12 4 za, sorry, 16 3 za. So this is 13. So 16 minus 13 is 3, 3, 1, 6. So 1 by 6. So 1 by f is equal to 1 by 16. Clear? Now the ratio in which the amount has to be shared is 1 by 8 is to 1 by 12 is to 1 by 16 is to 1 by 16. I'll convert this in terms of natural numbers, not the fraction, by multiplying everything by 48. So this, that will be 6 is to 12, 4 is to 48, 4 is to 3 is to 3. Now this is the fourth person's share. That will be nothing but 3 divided by 6 plus 4, 10, 3 plus 3, 6, 16 of 1200. So 4, 4 times 4, 3 times. Or 300 by 4 will be equal to how much? 25 into 3, 125. So 125, 300 by 4 is 125. 125 into 3. 300 by 4 is, I'm sorry, 300 by 4 is 75, right? 100 by 4 is 25, 300 by 4 is 75. 75 into 3 is 225. Option C. Great, next one. Okay, next question. Well, A can do a piece of work in 16 days, B in 24 days. With the help of C, they complete in 6 days. Total remuneration is 400 rupees. The amount each will receive, all right, in proportion to do the work is fine. Now, this can be solved in a very lengthier way also, but you know, the advantage of having options has to be considered. Now, I want the number of days that C does the work, all right, or C takes to complete the work. 1 by 6 minus 1 by 16 plus 1 by 24. What is this? 1 by 6 is the fraction of work done by all of them together, A, B, and C. 1 by 16 is that of A, and B, sorry, 1 by 24 is that of B. So if you calculate this, you will get the fraction of work done by C. 16, 24, LCM is 48, and then you have 3 times, 2 times, this becomes 5. So 1 by 6, I will write it as 8 by 48 minus, this will be equal to 3 by 48. Or 1 by 16. Now the ratio is of A, B, and C. A, B, and C is what ratio? Not the number of days. So when we are calculating the remuneration, we have to calculate, or it has to be in proportion to the amount of work they do. Great. So this is 1 by 16 This is 1 by 24 and this is 1 by 16. Now observe and take the advantage of options. The value of A and C must be same and that of B must be less than A and C. 1 by 24 is less than 1 by 16. Great. Look at the options. You have two options wherein A and C are same. So, but in option A, the value of B is less than A or less than C. But here in option D, it is more. So, the correct option is A. Simple. All right. Go to the next one. Next one. If a man earns 2000 for his first 50 hours of work in a week and is then paid 1.5 times his regular hourly rate for any additional hours, then the hours must he work to make 2300 in a week is? Well, if you look at the options and the question, they are asking about the extra hours that he has to work. All right, now 2000 rupees is what he can earn by working for 50 hours, the first 50 hours. So what's his hourly wage there? 2000 divided by 50, that will be equal to 200 by 5 or 40 rupees. He must be paid 1.5 times his regular hourly rate. So 1.5 times of this is equal to 40 plus 20, that is 60. What he has earned is extra 300 rupees. This, if you divide it by 60 rupees, you will get the extra hours, 5 hours. That's all. Option B. Great, simple. Go to the next. Okay. Well, here, look at this. They have also brought in the concept of this expenditure, rupees 450. Fine. Anyways, we can solve it. It's not difficult. The expenditure of gas on burning 6 burners for 6 hours a day for 8 days. Overall, this indicates the duration in which 6 burners are burnt. Basically, let's say simultaneously. To do that, the cost is 450 rupees. Now, if I increase either the number of burners or the duration, the cost will increase, right? In such a way that this particular value, that is 6 burners multiplied by duration, that is 6 into 8 divided by 450, has to be constant. Clear? Great. Now this value must also be equal to, in the second scenario, how many burners? Let's assume that to be n, and it has to be used for 10 days for 5 hours, and the expense, once again, it comes to denominator 625. Now solve it, you will get the answer. So you can remove K. 6 burners, let's remove that also. B, let's not confuse. 6 burners is equivalent to this N. The unit is same in both the cases. Great. Now, what I will do is, I will remove all this and bring it here. This 125 times, and this is 4500. So 125 three times, you have 375 and 750. 125 two times is 250. 250 three times is 750. So 125 six times, and you have 6 into 6. You can cancel that. You are left out with 8. So n is equal to 8. 8 burners. That is option D. Just be careful with the calculation, that's all. Great. Next one. Now, working 8 hours a day, A can complete a work in 8 days. Working 6 hours a day, B can complete the same work in 10 days. Basically, A takes 5 hours a day and works for 8 days. So overall, 40 hours. And what about B? 6 hours, 10 days, 60 hours. So when they work together, it's going to be 1 by 40 plus 1 by 60. You get 120 and then 5. So this value is 1 by 24, right? So overall, in 24 days and sorry in 24 hours A and B can complete the work. 24 hours is equivalent to how many days? If you know 8 hours a day is considered, that is equivalent to 3 days, right? Because 8 hours a day multiplied by 3 days gives you 24 hours. So the answer is 3 days. Clear? All right. Next one. Working efficiencies of P and Q. Working efficiency is given, I mean the ratio 3 is to 4. Number of days to be taken by them to complete the work will be in the ratio. That's pretty simple. The number of days and the working efficiency, they will always be in the inverse ratio. Basically, this is nothing but if this is in 3 is to 4, the number of days will be in the ratio of 1 by 3 is to 1 by 4, which is 4 is to 3. Great. Option D. This you should solve in within 5 seconds. Okay. Next one. Okay. Next one. A canteen requires 56 kgs of rice for 7 days. The quantity of rice required for the months of April and May. April, Jan, Feb, March, April, 30 days. May, 31 days. Right? Overall, it is for 61 days that we are calculating. So, if it is for 7 days, 56 kgs, then for 1 day, it is 56 divided by 7, which is equal to 8 kgs. For 1 day, the consumption in this canteen is 8 kgs. So, for 61 days, it is going to be 61 multiplied by 8, which is equal to 8, 48, 488. Option B. Great. Next one. All right. I have marked the answer as 9 hours. Let's see. Very simple question. Within 5 seconds or 10 seconds kind of question. 6 hours for 18 days. How many hours if he has to work for 12 days? That's it. All right. Great. Next one. Next one. Pipes and system. The concept remains the same. So, let's look at this. A tap can empty a tank in 1 hour. A second tap can empty it in 30 minutes. If both the taps operate simultaneously, how much time is needed to empty the tank? I'll express this also in terms of minutes. So that's the first thing. Okay, keep all the units same and let that be as similar to the options. Fine. So 1 by 60th is what? In 1 minute, what part of the tank can be emptied by tap A? Similarly, 1 by 30 is in 1 minute, how much part, what fraction of the tank can be emptied by second tap? Well, when you add that, you will get in 1 minute what fraction of the tank can be emptied by both of them simultaneously, when both of them are simultaneously open. This will be equal to 3 by 60. This is nothing but 1 by 30 is 2 by 60. So, this becomes 3 by 60 or 1 by 20. So, 1 by 20th fraction of the tank can be emptied in 1 minute. All right. So, that means that to completely empty the tank, it takes 20 minutes. That's it. Now, I'll tell you one more thing. We need not even solve all this to get the answer. Why? There is this this tap which empties the tank in 30 minutes. Now, when there is one more tap which is open, definitely both of them together will empty the tank in less than 30 minutes. And look at the options. There's only one option, which is option A, 20 minutes. Great? Fantastic. Go to the next one. Okay, two pipes A and B can separately fill a cistern in 60 minutes and 75 minutes respectively. There is a third pipe in the bottom of the cistern to empty it. If all the pipes are simultaneously opened, then the cistern is full in 50 minutes. In how much time the third pipe alone can empty the tank or cistern? Well, it's a very, very simple question. This is similar to two people working constructively. For example, let's say there is a compound and there are two people who are building it. and there is one person who is trying to destruct it. So three of them work together, and then you also know the number of days taken by three of them to completely build the wall. Obviously, the wall can be built only when the rate of work of the people who are constructing is more than the person who is destructing. Great. What do we do? We'll go with the same logic, that is, find out the efficiency of AB, that is nothing but 1 by 60, the amount of work done by A in 1 minute, amount of work done by B in 1 minute is 1 by 75. You can say instead of amount, we can use the word fraction of work done, that becomes more apt, minus the fraction of work done, that is nothing but the fraction of water emptied by the third tap is 1 by x. That is what we are supposed to find out. I mean the value of x. This is equal to 1 by 50 because in 1 minute, they are saying that 1 50th of the tank is getting filled. And how did I get it? Because they are saying it takes 50 minutes to completely fill the tank. If it takes 50 minutes to completely fill the tank, you can imagine the tank to be 50 parts. All right. That means every minute, one out of these 50 parts is getting filled. Great. So solve this equation. You will have 60, 75 and 50, the LCM. Go with the multiples of the biggest number. 75, 2 is 150 is not divisible, then 300. Great. So 300, 60, 1 by x will be equal to this minus 1 by 50, right? So yeah, 60 is 5 plus 75 is 4 minus 50 is 6. So this is equal to 1 by x. This value is how much? 3. 3 by 300. So the value of x is 100. What is x? X is the number of minutes taken by the third pipe to empty the tank. Clear? Fantastic. So the answer is option B. Well, these kind of questions are pretty, frequently asked, not just in SSE. If you are preparing also for other exams, the destructive work concept is usually asked. So be thorough with this concept. Great. Next one. 12 pumps working 6 hours a day can empty a completely filled reservoir in 15 days. So there are 12 pumps and overall duration, okay, total number of hours to completely empty this reservoir is 6 hours multiplied by 15 days. Fine. This value multiplied by the number of pumps remains constant for one particular reservoir. If the number of pumps increase, this value, the number of hours required to empty that, reduces. I hope this is clear. Now this is constant. Now this is equal to number of pumps is what they are asking for multiplied by 9 into 12. 9 hours working for 12 days. Great. Now if you look at the options, I mean there are values less than 12, 9 and 10. So let's solve it. 12, 12, 3, 2 and then 3 and then 5. So n is 10. Option C. Okay, this is a good question. Read it. A cistern is provided with two pipes, A and B. A can fill it in 20 minutes. B can empty it in 30 minutes. If A and B be kept open alternately, nice question. And you might get these kind of questions, if not for SSE, for any other exam. So there is one concept, understand this very clearly. You will be able to solve any of these kind of types in the future. Fine. So if A and B be kept open alternately for 1 minute each. Now see here, what they are saying is, let's say this is the overall time frame. 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes, it continues. Okay. So first minute, A is open. Second minute, B is open. So A fills the tank, B empties the tank. Next, A fills the tank, B empties the tank. So like this, it continues. So what we are supposed to find, is how soon will the cistern be filled? I will go with the LCM approach. It's easier to explain. 30 minutes, 20 minutes. I'll assume the capacity of the tank, okay? The capacity of the tank as LCM of 20 and 30, that is 60 units. It can be 60 liters, fine? Now, if that is the case, A fills 60 divided by 20, that is 3 units per minute. B fills 2 units per minute, that is 60 divided by 30. I'm sorry, B empties 2 units per minute, all right? Now, I'll write minus 2 units, okay? Now, what am I saying? The first minute, A fills 3 units, B empties 2 units. So, at the end of second minute, the tank is filled only with 1 unit. Clear? Now, this is the case. Now, what we are supposed to find out? How long it will take for both these taps to completely fill the tank? That is, the sum of everything, all these calculations, should be equal to 60 units. Now, since it is happening alternately, remember this, since this is happening alternately, you need to be a little careful. What I will do is, I'll try to find out when will the tank be full, not tank be full, but when will the tank will have 57 units. Why is that? Because if I get to know when it will fill 57 units, the next minute, okay, A will be open and A will fill the tank with 3 units and I will get 60 units. Okay, now for this to happen, there is one prerequisite, and that is for 57 units to get filled, the number of minutes has to be an even number. And why is that? Only then the next value will be A, because A is open at the odd place, that is first minute, third minute, fifth minute. Let's see if that happens. Okay, so 57 units, right? Effectively, after two minutes, one unit of water is getting filled. To fill 57 units, it will take 57 into 2, that is 114 minutes. Well, luckily, 114, what we have is an even number, and the next will be an odd number, wherein it is the chance of A now. Now, A will be open and A will fill 3 units on 115th minute. Okay, and this becomes 60 units. Great. So the answer is 115 minutes. If you do it directly, you will end up getting 120 minutes. Okay, so it will never be with a direct value. And why is that? It's just because there is a destruction happening. There is something, you know, at 120th minute also, the tank will be filled with 60 units. But the question is, how soon will the cistern be filled? How soon the cistern will be filled? At 115 minutes, it gets filled, 60 units. And then at 116th minute, what happens? 2 units will be emptied. Once again, it becomes, 58 units, because it was 60 units. So similarly, this happens. And then once again, at 120th minute, once again, the tank is full. But that is not what we are looking for. This is the catch. So every time when you have the question with respect to this, alternately, one person is constructing something and one person is destructing something, or one pipe is filling the tank and other pipe is emptying the tank, be careful with it. Find out the total work that has to be done and then subtract that value from the positive work. For example, here the positive work is contributed by A by 3 units. So what I have done, the total unit, what I've assumed as 60 units minus 3 gives me 57, and then find out the number of minutes what is required to fill these 57 units. That will be equal to 114 minutes, and then the next minute A will fill 3 more units, so that it becomes 60 units. I hope you followed it. Okay, great, fine. Let's move on to the next one. Okay, next one. A cistern has two pipes. One can fill it in 8 hours, other can empty it in 5 hours. Similar kind of question, you know, one is filling, other one is emptying. But who is more efficient here? The one which is emptying. Okay, so that is important. In how many hours will the cistern be emptied if both the pipes are opened together when 3/4 of the cistern is already full of water? So we'll take care of this part later. Now let's find out how long will it take for both of these pipes when they are open to completely empty the tank. Okay, that will be nothing but 1 by 5 is the rate at which it is getting emptied minus 1 by 8. This is LCM is 40 and 5 8 minus 8 5 3. So 3 by 40 is what? That's the fraction of water that is being emptied every hour. So it takes 40 by 3 hours to completely empty a full tank. Now in the question, what they have asked is to empty 3/4 of the cistern. So to empty the full tank, it takes 40 by 3. To empty 3/4 of it, it must take 3 by 4th of 40 by 3. It is equal to 10 hours. Option B. Great. All right. Next one. If 1/3 of a tank holds 80 liters of water, then the quantity of water that half tank holds is? Very simple question, right? 1/3 of tank holds 80 liters. That means the full tank holds 240 liters. That is 80 into 3. The quantity of water that half tank holds is 240 divided by 2. That will be equal to 120. Clear? Great. Next one. Okay. Three taps ABC can fill a tank in 12, 15 and 20 hours. A is open all the time. B and C are open for 1 hour each. Alternatively, the tank will be full in how many hours? Fine. I'll go with the LCM approach. LCM of 12, 15 and 20 is 60. I'll assume 60 liters as the capacity of this tank. Then what they say is A is open throughout. Okay, so A fills the tank throughout the whole episode of filling the tank. Then B and C, they are opened alternatively and they are adding the water. So here there is no removing the water or emptying the water, or there is no leakage concept here, right? So, but one thing is, if you observe, so in first hour, all right, A is first hour, A and B, they are open. In second hour, A and C are open. And then this cycle, all right, this cycle repeats. So third hour and fourth hour, the same thing will happen. A and B will be open on third hour, and fourth hour, it's going to be A and C. Correct. So let's first find out the value of this. A and B, if you see, the amount of water filled by A is 60 divided by 12, that is 5 units. What about by B? 4 units, that is 9. A, I know 5, and then C, it is 3. It is 8. So 9 plus 8 is 17. So in two hours, overall this whole setup fills the tank by 17 units. Okay. Now the overall capacity of tank that we have assumed is 60 units. Hope you are following this. Now find out the multiple of 17 less than 60. Right? I'll tell you why. So it is 17 2s are, it is 34, and then you have 51. Correct? Yes. Now observe. In two hours, 17 units is getting filled. Multiply 17 by 3, you get 51 units. So in 6 hours, 51 units is filled, right? So what happens on 7th hour? 7 is an odd number, so B is open. So this thing will happen. That is, A and B are open. So when A and B are open, it fills the tank with 9 units. So 7th hour, 9 units is filled. So you already have 51 units filled in the tank. 51 plus 9 becomes 60 liters, and your tank is full. Hope this is clear. So the answer is option C, 7 hours. Great. Next one. Okay, next one. Again, the similar kind of question. An empty tank can be filled by pipe A in 4 hours and by pipe B in 6 hours. If the two pipes are opened for 1 hour each alternately, with first opening pipe A and then B, right? Okay, great. Now, again, I'll go with the LCM approach. It's easy to do the calculations. LCM is of 4 and 6 is 12. So I'll assume 12 liters as the capacity of the tank. So in the first hour, A fills the tank by 12 by 4, 3 liters. Second hour, B fills the tank by 12 by 6, 2 liters. Okay. Now, this has to repeat until the tank becomes full. That is, it is filled by 12 liters. So this is 5 liters. So after 4 hours, another 5 liters gets filled. So I get 10 liters. Let's see what happens at 5th hour. 5th hour, what is open? A is open. It's an odd number. And A fills 3 liters. So if it fills 3 liters, it will become 13 liters. So that cannot happen. We need only 12 liters. So something happens. I mean, the tank will be filled at 5th hour. All right. So the answer is option C. No doubts about it. But let's find out what's the exact value. That is, pending is 2 liters. 10 liters is already filled after 4 hours. So now 2 liters divided by the capacity of, I mean, the efficiency of A is 3. So in 2 by 3 of overall 60 hours, it fills 2 liters. I hope this is clear. All right. So 2 by 3 of 60 is equal to 40 minutes. What is the 60? 60 minutes, basically. I have converted 1 hour to 60 minutes so that the calculation becomes easy. So you get 4 hours, 40 minutes. You need not do this. The moment you understand that, you know, this happens, the tank will be full on 5th hour, then the option has to be option C, because none of the other options is close to this. If there was one more option, let's say 4 hours, 20 minutes, then the next step, what we did, that is 2 by 3 of 60 minutes, was important. Okay, great. Okay, next one. Well, read this question. This is similar to the previous question, only the sentences has been reframed. These are two questions from the same year in two different settings. Okay, so it is wise, for example, if in case, you know, your exam is on one particular date, so whatever questions has appeared on the previous days, it's wise to just go and revise whatever has appeared, so that the types might repeat. You will get an understanding about you know, the pattern and the difficulty level of questions. Okay, and when we have observed in the previous years, the difficulty level has not risen up so much. Yes, to certain extent in 2016 and 17, the difficulty level is little higher, but not for all the questions. Out of 25 questions, around 10 questions will be on higher difficulty level, which you can solve it definitely by practicing things properly. Now, this question, you can just see 4 hours is pipe A and 6 hours is pipe B. So 4 hours and 6 hours, if two are opened for 1 hour each, the same thing here, if they are opened on alternate hours, it's the same thing, right? Where A is opened first, and here also with first opening pipe A. Great. So the answer is, see, the option has been given in a different way. 4.66 is nothing but 4 hours, 40 minutes. 0.66 is 2 by 3 of 60. You can see the previous video, the previous questions video. You will get the answer. It is option D. Great. go to the next one. Okay, we have reached the last question of the mock test. Hope you have attempted this and you know have scored more than 50 marks. It's a simple test. Approximately around 8 to 10 questions are difficult. Most of them can be solved within a minute. Well, the last question, and this is a very direct one. I have marked the answer already. Yeah. So 1 by P minus 1 by Q. They have clearly mentioned P is more than Q. P is less than Q. That means 1 by P is more than 1 by Q. Okay. So anything can be the reference. If the number of hours is lesser, that means that the efficiency of that particular pipe is higher. So 1 by P is more than 1 by Q refers to the fraction of water filled by P is more than the fraction of water emptied by Q. Only then the tank can be full. So the difference of this must be equal to the fraction of tank getting filled in 1 hour. So they have clearly mentioned the tank is filled in R hours. So 1 by R will be equal to the fraction of tank that is filled in 1 hour. So the answer is 1 by R is equal to 1 by P minus 1 by Q. Option B. That's it, guys. Great. Take up the remaining mock tests. It could be topic wise or full length. The idea is to be well versed with the pattern and the difficulty level of the previous year papers. You don't have to solve any other questions. We have only selected 60 questions from all the topics, which is okay. Along with this, also prepare only the previous year based questions or papers. That will be very helpful for you to prepare. You will be very streamlined. You know, you exactly know this is the pattern, this is the difficulty level and the topics. So you'll be very aware and thorough about your preparation. Great. All the best for your preparation. Take up the next mock test and watch the video solutions. Thank you.